Hello dear students, welcome once again to our channel Maths in Minutes with Priya. Today's clip 83 of this channel, and I'm going to begin with the topic time and speed. Today's part 1, we are going to cover all basic concepts. Many students find this topic very confusing because there is variety of problems. There are train crossing platform, or train crossing a man, then train coming from opposite direction or following the same direction, or then there are boats and streams, then there are convergent kilometer per second to meter per second, then there is average speed, and lots of confusing problems are there. And then students, what do? They prefer to skip this topic totally. So let's not do that. What we can do is, in every part of time and speed, I'll cover a different variety so that all your doubts get solved and you find this topic very easy. So let's begin today with the basics. As you know, whenever I begin any topic, part 1 always consists of basic examples. Now these examples are simple. In part 1 generally I cover simple examples. You may think ki itna simple example thodi aane wala exam mein. Then you are right. You may not get very simple examples in exam, but unless you understand the simple examples, then there is no point in covering the complex examples. Otherwise, what happens is this: students unnecessarily feel that this topic is difficult. Instead of that, it's good that you understand the basics and then proceed slowly. So let's begin today's topic. The positive side of time and speed is this: that you need to remember only one formula. Speed is equal to distance upon time. That's all. Now there are some shortcut formulae also, which we are going to cover in coming parts, part 2, part 3, part 4, etc. But even if you forget those shortcuts and if you understand use of this formula, then you really don't require any other formula. So what I'm going to do, whatever examples I solve in every part, I'm going to show you how to make use of this simple formula instead of using different shortcuts. What is speed? Speed is distance upon time. What is meant by this? See, when you say something like this, that I walk very fast, I cover 1 kilometer in 5 minutes. Do you say I walk very fast, I cover 1 kilometer? That doesn't make any sense. Walking 1 kilometer doesn't indicate whether you are walking fast or slow. Kisi ko 1 kilometer chalne mein 15 minute lagega, kisi ko 2 minute lagega, kisi ko 5 minute. So your speed depends on time also. So speed takes into consideration both these parameters: how much distance you are covering and in how much time you are going to cover it. So speed is equal to distance upon time. S is equal to D upon T. From this, what do we understand? If T goes here, denominator when it changes the side becomes numerator. It becomes distance is equal to S into T. So what is T? S can come to denominator when it changes side. T is equal to D upon S. So speed is equal to distance upon time. This we know from this formula itself. We can get these two formulae. These three are not different formulae. They are one and the same. S is equal to D upon T. D is equal to ST. Or T is equal to D upon S. Ye sab kuch by heart karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Sirf itna yaad rakho. S is equal to D upon T. Speed is equal to distance upon time. Now about unit of speed. Speed is generally given in kilometer per hour or meters per second. When distance is in kilometer, time is in hour, then speed is in kilometer per hour. When distance is given in meter, time in seconds, then speed unit becomes meters per second. But sometimes you need to convert. While solving examples, kilometer per hour should be converted to meter per second, or meter per second needs to be converted to kilometer per hour. In which type of examples we need to convert that we will see later. Examples we will see later. First, we will understand how to make the conversion. Now I need to convert kilometer per hour to meter per second. How do I convert? What is 1 kilometer? 1 kilometer is 1000 meter and 1 hour is 3600 seconds. So 1 kilometer per hour means 1000 meter in 3600 seconds. Now I can reduce it further. 5/18. So 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 5/18 meters per second. So whenever I have to convert kilometer per hour to meter per second, what I have to do? I have to multiply it by 5/18. And if it is other way, that is meter per second is to be converted to kilometer per hour, then I have to multiply by its reciprocal, that is 18/5. So kilometer per hour to meter per second is multiplying by 5/18. Meter per second to kilometer per hour is multiplying by 18/5. Now again, don't try to by heart this. I have shown you the conversion. By heart karoge to kya hota hai exam mein? Ma'am, 5/18 se multiply karne ki 18/5 se yaad nahi aa raha. So don't by heart. Use this common sense. Jab yaad rakhne ki zarurat hi nahi hai. 1 kilometer per hour to meter per second kaise hota hai? This is 1000/3600 means 5/18. So for converting from this to this, you have to multiply by 5/18 or ulta hoga to 18/5. That's all. Use this common sense. Now let's proceed to examples. Suppose I need to convert this 54 km per hour to be converted to meter per second. Then what do I need to do? 54 multiplied by 5/18. 18 ones are 18 threes are 5 threes are 15. So this is 15 meter per second. 54 km per hour is same as 15 meters per second. If I need to convert 30 meters per second to kilometer per hour, ab ye ulta hai, then what I need to do? I need to multiply by 18/5. So 30 is multiplied by 18/5. 5 ones are, 5 6 are, 18 6 are 108. So 108 kilometer per hour. 30 meters per second becomes 108 kilometers per hour. Got this? Now let's see this very basic example. A man covers 27 kilometers in 3 hours. Find out the speed. What is the formula? S is equal to D upon T. D is 27, T is 3. This is kilometer and this is hour. So your answer is in kilometer per hour or kmph. You can call it either kmph. See there, either write it like this, kmph or kilometer per hour, meaning is same. So your answer is 9 kilometer per hour. But suppose the options given are in meter per second, then what you will do? You need to now convert this to meter per second. So just multiply it by 5/18. 9 ones are, 9 twos are. So this is 5/2, which is same as 2.5. So 2.5 meters per second, that will be your answer. So I answer can be either this or this as per the options given. Jo char option diye hue hote hai, you have to check that whether it is in kilometer per hour or meter per second. Next example. A man covers a certain distance at the speed of 2.5 meters per second in 3 hours. Find the distance in kilometers. Now what is happening here? Time is given in hours, distance question is in kilometer, but speed is in meter per second. This is T is in hour, D should be in kilometer, but speed is in 2.5 meter per second. So what we need to do here? We need to convert it to kilometer per hour. And how do we convert? We multiply it by 18/5. So let's do it. So 9 kilometer per hour, that is the speed. So S is 9, t is 3 and we want d. S is equal to d upon t and we want distance. So distance t idhar chala gaya, s into t. S is 9, t is 3, 9, 3 is a 27, so distance is 27 kilometer. This example is oral example, but I have written all the steps just to explain. In exam, if you get examples like this, then try to do it orally only. It's very easy. So what is the first step we did? First, we observed the units. Distance should be in kilometer, time is in hour, that means speed should be converted to kilometer per hour. That's what we did and we found out the distance. Got this? Next example. A car covers a distance of 500 meter in 2 minutes. Find the speed in kilometer per hour. Either they will write kmph or kilometer per hour, meaning is same. So now here distance is given in meters, time is given in minutes, and we want the speed in kilometer per hour. So what we can do here? We can first find out the speed in meter per second and then we can convert it. But here seconds are not given, minutes are given, so we can convert them to second. First we will find the speed in meter per second. 500 meter is the distance, time is 2 minutes, that is 2 into 60 seconds. So this is 25 upon 6 meters per second. Speed is 25 upon 6 meter per second. We want it in kmph. So let us convert it. Let us multiply it by 18 upon 5. Is a 15 kmph. Got it? So here seconds was not given, minutes were given, but we easily converted it to second. We found out the speed in meter per second and then converted it to kmph. A man runs at the speed of 12 kmph. In how much time will he cover the distance of 500 meters? And see the answers: 3 seconds, 2.5 seconds, 2.5 minutes, 180 seconds, 2 minutes. So minutes and seconds answer are given in different units. So let us find out and then we will match these options. Now distance is in meter and time is in either minute or second, but the speed is in kilometer per hour. So what we can do here? We can convert this to meter per second. Then it will be easy for us because distance is in meters. So first let us convert 12 into 5 upon 18. This is meter per second, which is equal to distance upon time. Distance is 500. Time is unknown. We need to find the time. See, speed is equal to distance upon time, isn't it? So what I did here, in place of S, I wrote 12 into 5 by 18 because I want the speed in meter per second, is equal to distance, that is 500, t is unknown, we need to find t. So for finding t, what now we have to do? T will go here and this will come here. So 18 to numerator and 5 and 12 to denominator, ulta sulta. See, you need to be very good in fraction, multiplication, division, conversion to decimal point. If you are not good in this, please watch my earlier videos in which I have covered everything, all fractions, operations, everything I have covered. Please watch those. You must be very fast in this type of operations. You will get the answer in seconds. Why? Because you have converted speed in meter per second. Your distance is in meter. So whatever answer you will get it in seconds. 150 seconds. Is it there? Here, 150 seconds. Seconds mein kya kya hai? 3 seconds, 2.5 seconds, 180 seconds. Ye tino to nahi hai. Answer is 150 seconds. But Still two more answers are there in minutes. So what we will do? We will convert this into now minutes. How to convert second into minutes? 60 seconds is 1 minute. So we have to divide this 150 seconds by 60. When I divide 15 by 6, I get 2.5. Again, converting fraction to decimal point, you must be very fast. You must do it orally as far as possible. So 2.5 minutes, that's your answer, or 2 minutes 30 seconds, that your answer. Here 2.5 minutes is given to us, so that is the answer. A man can walk with a speed of 4 km/h. He takes half an hour to reach his office. What should be his speed if he wants to save 10 minutes? Speed is again equal to distance upon time, we all know. So what is speed here? 4. Now they are asking us what should be his speed if he wants to save 10 minutes. For that we must know the distance between home and office. So with this information, 4 and half an hour, with this information, now first we will find the distance. So speed is 4, distance is unknown, and half hour, that is the time. So for finding this, this half will go now here. So 4 into half. So distance is 2 km. Now they are saying what should be his speed if he wants to save 10 minutes. So now we have to find the speed. Distance we know is 2 km. And now time becomes 20 minutes. Earlier he was requiring half an hour, that is 30 minutes. But now he wants to save 10 minutes. That means now time is 20 minutes. Got it? So what is the speed? Now distance is in kilometer. So we need to convert time to hour so that we will get the speed in kilometer per hour. How to convert minutes to hour? 60 minutes is 1 hour. So to convert, we need to divide by 60, 20 upon 60, that is 1 by 3. So speed is equal to 2 upon 1 by 3. What is dividing by 1 by 3? That means multiplying by the reciprocal. So this is 2 into 3 by 1. 2 upon 1 by 3 means ulta ho jata hai, 2 into 3 by 1, that is 6. 6 kilometer per hour. Again, I am telling you, you should be fast at these calculations. Otherwise, what will happen is this: you know all the principles of speed and distance, but you do not know how to multiply using fractions, then you will lose all your marks. If you are in school, at least you will get 1 mark out of 2, but if you are a competitive exam aspirant, you are not going to get any mark because you are not able to find the answer itself. Right? So please watch my earlier videos if you are not able to solve such type of expressions. So your answer here is 6 km per hour. What we did here, first we found out the distance in kilometers, then we converted this minute to hour, and that's how we found the speed in kilometer per hour. Understood this example? So today I have covered all basic examples and basic concepts and convergence. From next time onwards, we are going to solve the different examples. In every part, we will solve the examples that will cover a specific variety. If you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, Maths in Minutes with Priya, please do so. It's absolutely free. So see you in the next part. Till then, stay happy, stay blessed. Bye for today.